So here's a view of it with the transmission off, before the transmission would go on, where the holes don't show up that well. But here's one, there's one, there's one, and somewhere around where that little blob is. And here is the here are the two Lovejoy couplers connected with some electrical tape. I'm going to have to seal that little final piece there. This piece at the top that's been welded on was taken out of the clutch hub, and it was welded on to a Lovejoy coupler, and then the bottom piece that you can't see is another Lovejoy coupler that connects to this top one. And the bottom one just sits, has a keyway, and it just sits right on the motor shaft. And notice these dark bolts. These are actually grade 8 bolts, just to be safe so that they're extra strong. Basically, the idea is to take 2 1/4-inch steel plates, connect them with spacers that are the appropriate length, so that your transmission shaft meets up with your motor shaft, and they measure up just perfectly with using the Lovejoy couplers. So I used aluminum, 1-inch diameter aluminum. There's 12 of these, and it doesn't matter where you drill them. Just space them all the way around, and make sure that these aluminum pieces are the same length, as close as possible. These are within about 0.2 millimeters of each other. That's hard work. And you drill a hole through them, and see underneath, each bolt goes through to the other side and is actually inside the bell housing here. The next thing you have to do is drill the holes to connect the motor, the face of the motor, to this bottom plate. That's also not very difficult. Basically, you just put the plate on top of the motor and just drill the 6 holes around it. In this case, it's 6 holes. Next, you have to drill the transmission mounting holes. So I mark those with some paint. There's, in the case of a VW Beetle, there's only 4 of them. And then we're going to drill those 4 holes through the steel plate. But we found the center. We found where they need to be based on testing it. So we're going to hook it up right here. First, we're going to get our little baby out of the way. Oh, he dropped his... We're going to hook up the motor and start running it, and you basically wiggle the transmission around, because it'll have a tiny bit of play to it, until it sounds pretty quiet, and that's where you lock it down into place and mark where your holes are going to be. So here we go. We'll demonstrate how it can run here. Transmission's running and it's pretty quiet, and that's all there is to it. The next thing we have to do is put the transmission back in the car, and then hook the motor back to the transmission. Yeah. And we just got the motor installed in the back. And are you ready for the little post to spin? First gear. Whoops. Let's stick it in reverse.
Is it still recording?
Mm-hmm.
Is it going backwards?
Woo!
Sorry. Let me stick it in fourth gear, see if it goes really fast. Okay, here's fourth gear. It should spin faster, but maybe not. I don't really know. Yeah, it does. Whoa, that's screamingly fast. Okay, that's it. Hooray, it worked.
Unspeakable feelings ever.